Professor Charles Kwesiga's voice sadly lowers as he strongly fights back tears, recalling the life and friendship he shared with the late Mutebile as far back as the early 1970s.
A couple weeks to go. It's hard to take. Very hard to take. But that's the reality of life.
Kwesiga had in February 1972 been incarcerated in Mutukula prison on political charges. It was here that he witnessed a horrifying act. 561 of the 625 prisoners at the facility were murdered in cold blood. The murdered included Hassan Muhammadi, who had been the head of the criminal investigation department and investigated Brigadier Okoya's murder. Brigadier Okoya was an army officer allegedly murdered by Idi Amin in relation to the attempted assassination of the then President Milton Obote in 1969.
And so Okoya was assassinated while on leave in his upcountry place in Macholi. From Hassan Mohammed's investigation, the finger was pointing at Amin.
Kwesiga says the government announced that the survivors had been pardoned but they remained hunted. It was after this that together with his friends Emmanuel Mutebile and Martin Mwesiga, they embarked on what Kwesiga described as a dangerous journey to Kabale to recruit for the FRONASA.
And at that time, Emmanuel Mutebile was at Makerere University, where he had started showing his qualities of a leader.
He says during the trip, they had disagreements on what strategy they would use during the recruitment, and it was Mutebile who acted as a mediator.
We had a bit of a debate that was getting a bit out of hand, and Mutebile again now changed roles and became the peacemaker.
He singles out Mutebile, former Prime Ministers Amama Mbabazi and Ruhakana Rugunda, Elia Kategaya and Akena as people instrumental in ensuring his safety.
A few standout friends who would be daring enough to give us shelter, to give us solace, to give us support and even upkeep. Those are the ones I'm singling out.
Life took them to different directions, with Mutebile heading to the United Kingdom and Kwesiga to the United States, where he lived for over 30 years. He says they kept in touch to the last hour when Mutebile passed away this week.
Mutebile had been corroborating my story, and now it's just me. All my other three colleagues are gone.
Story compiled by Benwin Ojiambo for the news.